Hey, check it out.
Just them?
Guess so. That city they're headed to, is that...
Junar. Shinra territory. Come on.
Said to roost on an island's abandoned reactor, though there's no longer any way to reach the island. Or at least, none that I'm aware of.
Nature's finally reclaiming what Shinra stole.
Well, even if we could get there, I'd rather not bother. Didn't seem very friendly.
Agreed. Let's focus on where we can go.
I got your number.
Wave tower.
Okay.
I This one's for you!
Nothing to it.
Shaky.
Shall we pay that tower a visit?
Don't overdo it.
Can you take over for
me? Yes, it's my turn! Suck on me!
This one's for you!
Suck that! I'm gonna make you regret. What's wrong? Oh, you in trouble! trouble now. Move! Got him! Don't stop now!
That's no time thing. To celebrate.
Data, I was able to locate an old Republic transmitter chip. It can be found within a derelict structure that sits upon the coastline. This area is mottled with craters resulting from intense warfare between the Republic and Shinra. Do mind your step as you proceed.
careful.
Crow's Nest. Base of operations for our anti-Shinra activities.
Sorry, but we're keeping things locked down after the trouble in Under Juno.
Communications tower sighted.
With me!
Let's finish this.
Let's get to it!
You're up! With me!
Gotcha!
Safe. like Chocobo Country.
Good bird.
So all of this is Junon?
Everything above us. Below is under Junon.
Little more than an impoverished fishing village.
Figures. Shinra's always gotta have someone to stomp on. It's their friggin' MO.
One moment. Welcome to Under Junon, our sunless oasis. My name is Rhonda. I'm the mayor and sheriff around these parts. Could turn you in and be $100,000 richer for it.
Well, you know what they say, can't take it with you.
And Aerith to boot, huh? That's another $500,000 on top.
$500,000?
Down here, though, we know when to turn a blind eye. Consider our lips sealed.
Sorry, but I call bullshit.
Well, I don't think you would if you knew even half of what my town's been through. You don't like it? Leave. But over there, there's a quiet little inn where everyone's welcome.
Any guys in black robes pass through?
Not that I saw. Did see some black suits, though. Two guys and a girl. Looked pretty tough.
Well, well.
They made a beeline right for the elevator.
Now we're talking.
No, don't even think about it. In case it isn't obvious, upstairs is Shinra turf. And the same goes for the elevator as well. Don't ask me what, but the company's got something big planned up there. And security is tight. You start anything? Anything at all? And there will be consequences. Behave yourselves now. You'll be safe here. Relax.
Care what she said. There's gotta be black robes around here somewhere, so how are we gonna find them?
That would depend on where they are headed. If they mean to continue west, there are only two ways off this continent, by sea or by air.
Right. Might want to ask around town then. Locals will know routes not on the map. May have even seen stragglers pass through, or got boats for rent or something.
How about we meet at the inn when we're done?
Sounds good. And remember, low profile.
Come and visit under Junon, where the water's mako green.
Oh, made your way out here, huh? Mind if I get a shot of you?
Thank you.
Under Junon's a fascinating little town. Their water is especially so. I mean the color. This beauty comes at a dangerously high price, though. It's worth documenting before it's gone. Anyway, if you know any other camera-worthy subjects...
Shinra's rigs are sturdy as all hell. So big, they barely rock.
Have you met Priscilla yet? You'll know her when you see her.
They got any new books here?
Hey there! Looking to augment your folios? Hope you found what you needed.
So they don't have
comics? Oil, coal.
Many years ago, this stretch of ocean was home to the Republic of Junon's capital, a floating city built atop a fleet of interconnected ships. Now, that once proud metropolis is mere flotsam, courtesy of Shinra. In its place, the company built a new, unsinkable City of Steel, to stand as a warning to any who might dare to oppose them, or so I was taught. Many years ago, a floating city built atop a fleet.
Is there a new edition of Clear Skies?
Children of the planet, listen. Heed the voice of our great mother.
Wait, you want to buy something? Here? Thank you so, so much!
Sometimes window shopping ain't enough.
Word around town is Shinra's holding some kind of big event up top. Wonder what? The people here? They hate the lack of sunlight, but not me. I like it this way. Though I'd never tell them that, of course. Word around town is wonder what?
Must be a crowd.
What can I do you for?
Elevators are only way up, but Rhonda won't thank us if we storm it. She wasn't kidding when she said it was well guarded. Got any other ideas? Elevators are only way up, but Rhonda won't thank us if we storm it.
Thank you.
Some fishing village this is. Ain't even allowed to take a rowboat out. Shinra's saying it's only a temporary prohibition. But people gotta eat. Anyway, short of stealing a boat and cut waters here used to be teeming with fish. Practically, but ever since the offshore reactor came online, only things caught in the nets are monsters. And I ain't talking tuna. Shinra just couldn't help themselves. Had to go in some fishing. Shinra's saying short of stealing a boat and causing a scene, both us and our black robe friends are SOL.
Another day in a life without sunshine.
In the old days, you could make it.
Believe it or not, there's a reactor at the bottom of the crater.
Oh, well, would you look at... Bet you thought you could blow me up. Well, think again. I'm this town, and I've caught much bigger you young'uns can thrash all. All right.
I'm a fisherman, not a businessman. Shinra.
Boy, oh boy.
No, sorry, the ship won't be leaving port until the festivities are over.
We should have never let them build a reactor in our waters.
All right, everyone, come again.
Another day in a life without sunshine.
Thanks. Be bed like a man died.
Of course, if you troll the waters with a company ship, you're bound to break.
Ocean's real quiet.
I swear.
Hello there. Room for one. You're some kind of fighter, aren't you? That was Priscilla. From the sound of it, she needs a tough guy like you.
We gotta go! Now! There's a monster attacking the boat! This way! Down here! Quickly!
Okay.
Please!
Thank you.
Shinra's most wanted. Get rid of that thing.
Say what?
Barret, focus.
Get its attention.
On it.
The water.
Ugh!
in.
Oh, no, you don't.
Girl, come on. I don't think she's breathing.
Hey, we need help over here.
God, she's so cold.
Somebody, help!
Oh, I need to get her breathing again.
Maybe someone should go find a doctor?
There's no time.
And there, help me! You're on chest compressions.
Got it.
Now, start!
You picked the wrong girl, creep! What?
Those guys there are from the Splinter Cell.
Splinter Cell?
They used to be with Avalanche, but left after a policy dispute.
Easy. They're guests of mine. And this one was trying to save your life.
He was? Ugh, nice going, Yuffie. Call the guy a creep, why don't you? You big moron! Dum 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 dum.
Okay, Yuffie. Let's get you inside. You've had a rough day.
Yeah. All right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome! Not to beat that guy, but kids these days, I swear.
Now.
Who was that?
Another one of my guests. I seem to get a lot of them when the world's on fire.
Ocean's real quiet today. Too quiet. Something's brewing. I can tell you that much. When an old soul...
Hey, you guys are that Avalanche Splinter Cell, right?
Now, how the hell did you...
I just gotta say, I'm a big, huge fan of yours. HQ wishes they could be as cool as you guys.
Well, we are pretty cool, but...
Think we could sit down for a chat later? Got a teensy favor to ask. And gotta thank you for before.
I suppose you could come by the inn tomorrow.
Sweet! You won't be sorry. Promise. Later!
I know she laid it on pretty thick. But hey, she's just a kid. What's the harm in hearing her out?
Maybe she wants your autograph.
Come on, let's get ourselves some rooms.
Hey, if it isn't the heroes of... Thank you so much. Your stay is on us.
Now then, how many we got?
Could you make it...
5 it is. Oh, everything is comped. So if you need anything at all, just ask.
Don't know about you, but I'm dying to put my feet up.
It's nice to have the place booked up again for once. Gosh, When was the last time that happened?
It's open. Hey, so about that Yuffie kid, be honest.
Maybe she wants to join Avalanche.
Normally, I wouldn't turn anyone away, but she's just too young. Don't have the time or patience to babysit. I'll break it to her gentle. Shinra didn't waste any time getting our names and faces out. Rest up while you can. I'll let you know if anything happens.
I could feel them slipping away, one by one, and the tighter I held on, the more I lost.
I know. I felt the same. It was like they were sucking them straight out of my head.
Is that I don't even know what's missing. Only that something is. Like it's on the tip of my tongue, but I just can't remember.
Damn whispers.
Speaking of, you seen them lately? Cloud.
Who's in there with you?
Oh.
Right. Thought it was someone else.
Nope. All clear here, officer. Well, hope the rest of your patrol is just as uneventful. Come in. About you, but it feels like I wonder how Mom and Marlene are holding up.
Homesick?
No time for that, not with Sephiroth around. So, a little random, but do you remember the first time we met?
You shoved a flower in my face.
It's called a gift, Cloud. I saw it, you know, in a vase at Seventh Heaven. And I seriously doubt you're the one who put it there.
Hey, I mean, you never know.
Some advice? Never re-gift a present from a girl. Especially if you're just gonna give it to another one.
Noted.
Water under the bridge. But next time... Where do you think those guys in black went? We should have seen them by now. Gotta wonder what Shinra's planning up there.
Thank you.
This town reeks. Should Shinra come calling, I doubt I'll smell them till it's too late.
We'll manage.
It feels like I have fish bones in my nose. My poor nose.
Perfect timing. I was just about to come find you.
Yeah, I...
You...
regret what I said in calm.
Oh. Come in.
I should have never doubted you.
It's fine. I never should have doubted you either. Say, do you remember a guy named Emilio from Nibelheim?
The general store kid?
Yeah. Anyway, he left the village right before you did. Thought I'd never see him again. Then one day last year, he shows up at Seventh Heaven. I couldn't believe my eyes. He was all grown up. Didn't even recognize him at first.
Really?
Yeah, and what's more, the woman who walked in with him was stunning. Like, she could have been a model, and... You're not interested, are you?
Not really. But I'm happy to listen, so go ahead.
It's okay. Forget it.
Was this another test?
No, it wasn't. I... Why deny it? I guess it was, huh? I'm sorry.
It's fine. We'll find time to talk. Just the two of us. Figure things out.
Just be ready to spill your guts, huh?
With my iron stomach?
Night.
Turn in early tonight.
that the gang's all here, it's time you got to know me. My name is Yuffie, materia hunter and elite ninja operative for the interim Wutai government. I left my beloved homeland behind to bring an end to Shinra's reign of terror and prove that Wutai's not to be trifled with!
Wutai?
Yep. Which brings me to that little favor I mentioned yesterday. Long story short, I want you to join me. HQ, they just didn't understand, but you guys get it.
Don't ninjas creep around in the dark slitting people's throats? I mean, we've done some shit, but we ain't about to stoop that low.
I resent that! Although, that is something we do. Traveling alone so far from home is expensive. So I've been moving from town to town, hustling, scraping together enough scratch to keep sticking it to the man. Until, that is, I came here. And lucky I did, because I met Rhonda. She offered me the gig of a lifetime, an assassination. And guess who the target is? Seriously, guess!
Just spit it out already.
Who else but a certain company's new president, Rufus freaking Shinra! That crazy or what? And that douchebag will be here any minute now. Up there here, anyway. Enjoying his fancy inauguration parade. These people had their country stolen from them, and then their sunlight. Junon demands revenge. So when the president steps out...
Oh, wow. Tell us more.
Okay. You want to know how Rhonda's planning on paying me? With your bounty suckers.
What?
Wow, gotta hand it to her. The lady works fast. Well, this was fun. See ya.
Hey!
I know you're in there, my friend.
If you manage to get away, you should try to find Priscilla. She'll get you topside.
Now. You don't want to make me come in there and fetch you, because I would love to do it.
Who's that?
A pain in the ass. Let's go.
Honestly, how long do you intend to keep me waiting? Absence certainly makes the heart grow fonder, my friend. Still playing hard to get, eh? Well, I've got news for you, young man. As if by fate, the Speed Demon has been entrusted with a singular task. Retrieving one Aerith Gainsborough.
Me?
You come alone?
It only takes two to tango. Besides, you and I like to go big, and a venue this small just won't do. But no need to worry. I found the perfect stage. The city above, where we can dance up a storm. Seek me out, and we'll put our last performance to shame. With a show none shall ever forget.
You got some weird friends, man.
We might want to think about getting out of here. These people don't need more trouble.
Yuffie said to talk to Priscilla if we wanted to get topside, right? Let's go find her.
Thanks for dealing with that Shinra nut job.
Don't you think for even a second we did that for you, the slime ball who sold us out?
Take it. Not much, but it's yours.
The hell's this supposed to be?
Your bounty. Part of it, anyway. You thought I'd put you through the ringer like that without making it worth your while? We're on the same side. Always have been.
And what if Biker Boy had taken us in?
Then I would have had to improvise. But I didn't, because it all worked out. Worked out fine. Like I pray it will for you, Fee, upstairs.